These three sensors are identical, except the 12 has a 6.2 meter range, while the 13 and the 14 have a 10 meter range, and the difference between these two is the 13 has an extra output, A2, a dedicated laser enable, and dedicated output pins. The 12 and the 14 have all the same functionality as the 13. You can configure pin A1 to be the analog output, and pin A3 to be the laser enable, for example. So if your needs are simple, either of those two will do everything the 13 does, you just have fewer pins to do it with. Setting up these sensors is pretty easy once you get the hang of using the menus. This chart from the online manual shows you all the possible commands. In this video, we'll do all the simple ones. These guys right here require a little more explanation, so we'll cover those in separate videos. Here we go. If you're reconfiguring an existing unit, you'll probably want to get it back to factory default just so you have a known starting point. Just press any of the three buttons to get into the menus, and hit the up or down arrows until you see the word reset. Press the right arrow to go down to that menu, and then you press the R button to reset the sensor to factory default. There's a list of all of the default settings on page 11 of the user manual. Now, the factory reset is great, except for one thing. The default language on this unit that I'm using is German. And since I don't speak German, the menus are kind of difficult to figure out. Well, here's a little tip. Press any button to get into the menus, and you can see all the German menus. Well, we want to change the language to English, but since the menu's in German, there is no language option, right? But if I scroll through these options, there's one called Sprache. Have you ever heard the phrase, Sprechen Sie Deutsch? Meaning, do you speak German? Well, that's this Sprache right here. We press the right arrow, scroll down to English, then press the right arrow to accept that, and then back arrow to exit. We can either wait for the sensor to revert to run mode, or just scroll down to run and hit the right arrow. And that's pretty much how the menus work. We can do things like set the sample rate, turn the laser beam on or off, etc., just by following these little arrows. Let's go through these one by one and see what they do. This run mode is interesting. Here you can change the run mode display between analog and digital. This run option right here gives you a quick way to get back to the run mode so you can see the result. So let's see, in the digital mode, we see the distance readout, the status of the pins, along with this bar graph indicating where we are in the range. In the analog mode, we see the actual current or voltage at the output pin. The display menu lets you flip the display upside down. This gives you flexibility in how you mount the sensor. You can also set the default intensity, and you can choose between an energy saver and screen saver modes. Energy saver turns the display off if you're in run mode and there's no button activity for about 1 minute. Screen saver mode reduces the intensity of the display and inverts the screen once a minute to help extend the life of the screen. Let's speed up the video here so you can see what that looks like. Remember, this actually happens once a minute. Again, pressing any button brings it back to the normal display. The info screen shows you the current software version, part number, etc. The laser menu lets you manually force the laser light on or off. That way, if you're working on the system and you don't want the laser light bouncing all over the place, you can just force it to be off. The password screen lets you create a password, which can be any number from 0 to 9999. And then you enable the password here. So if the sensor loses power, then you won't be able to access the menus without knowing the password. This measure rate menu item is the sample rate. Note that reducing the sample rate improves the resolution for this sensor. So if resolution is important to you, choose the lowest sample rate you can for your application. And finally, the analog menu is where you choose current or voltage output and set or teach the min and the max distances. To set new ones, just move the target to the max distance and press this upper button, in this case, the 10 volt output. That would say 20 milliamps if we had chosen the current output, of course. Then move the object to the nearest distance and hit the bottom button to lock in the distance at which you want to get 0 volts, or 4 milliamps of current if you chose that mode. Easy. To get back to run mode at any time, you can either wait 60 seconds or scroll down to run and hit that button. Well, that should be enough to get you started with these distance sensors from Wengler. Check out the next video to learn how to configure those input and output pins. And don't forget, Automation Direct's tech support is always free, and you'll talk to a real live person here in the U.S. within minutes. Got a question? During business hours, you can call, email, or even do online chat. Automation Direct offers Wengler distance measuring sensors from 80 micrometers all the way out to 100 meters to cover all of your distance measuring needs.